have a teachers in grad school collab. Hello everyone and welcome to my channel. My name is Marieli Sanchez and I'm a fourth grade teacher in South Florida. So for today's video, I have a very special collab that was started by Sheridan from Excellently Elementary, along with a group of other teacher YouTubers that I will be sure to link in the description box below. And be sure to check out their channels as well for their video, and also because they're just amazing teacher YouTubers that I have the pleasure of knowing. So I have a teachers in grad school collab, and I have a set of 10 questions that I'm going to answer based on my experience going into grad school. Now for me, it's a little special because I'm going to be talking about both my master's program and my current PhD program. So I'll be sure to answer questions related to both and see how they kind of intermingle in some way or another as we go along. So let's start right off with question number one. What did you study in grad school? All right, so for my master's, I got a master's in science in educational technology applications. So I basically love technology. I love integrating it into instruction and finding new ways to do so. So I really, really wanted to get a degree in technology. Now, this is a fun fact. Each of my brothers, my two brothers and myself, all have a degree in one way or another in technology. We actually give thanks for this to our dad because ever since we were very little, we had an Atari. We were introduced to our first computer, which was an Amiga computer, and my dad taught us basic DOS language to activate it and have the games play on the computer. So it really influenced me because that caused me to get a degree in technology. So that's where my master's is. And thanks to that degree, I have been able to actually teach at the university level for 2 semesters. So far, I was an adjunct professor teaching teachers how to integrate technology into reading instruction. I'm really passionate about technology. Even before starting my YouTube channel, I had an online presence since 2002 when I first started my website. And then from there, I started going into discussion boards like ProTeacher and helping teachers out and learning from teachers. So natural progression, now I'm a YouTuber. So thank you, Dad, for influencing us with technology. And that's why I got my master's in educational technology. Now for my PhD, I'm getting it in curriculum and instruction, specializing in reading, literacy, and cognition. I actually wanted to get a PhD in something that I'm passionate about, which is writing. And in the universities in my area, there wasn't really any that were offering an actual degree just on writing, but this one was the closest that I can actually connect that passion to. And I just love everything reading and learning about how the brain learns to read, learns to write, and seeing how it impacts the way that teachers also teach and the different ways that students learn. And it's just been a passion of mine. So those are the areas that I'm getting my postgraduate degrees in, or have already gotten since I already have my master's. So question number two, how long did it take you to complete your degree? So for my master's, I started that degree in 2005. And I graduated in 2008. Now I did finish in 2007, but I had missed my deadline for graduation by a couple of weeks. So then I had to wait for the following semester, which was in 2008. So I graduated in May 2008 with my master's. It didn't take that long. It took about 2 years. And I also had a toddler with me because my son was 3 years old when I started my master's. And by the time I finished, he was going to be almost 6 years old. So yeah, I was a single mom. I was still living at home though with my parents, who were great help, but I was a full-time teacher and going to school to get my master's. Now for my PhD, I actually started my PhD in 2012. By then my son was 10 years old, and right now currently my son is 16, going on 17. So it's taken me a while to get through my PhD, but not because of the courses per se. I did take 2 to 1 course depending on the semester, and one course in a PhD program, believe it or not, is actually considered full-time because of all the different assignments that you have to do. So when I was taking 2 classes, they actually told me, slow down, you're like taking way too many things, because I'm also a full-time teacher and still a mom. I finished around 2016 my classes, passed my comprehensive exams, And right now I'm on dissertation mode. I'm what's called ABD, which is all but dissertation. So I completed all my coursework. I passed all my exams. I just have to sit down and write the dissertation. They give us actually 7 years from our start date, which is my deadline is coming up soon, but I can actually request an extension and hopefully they'll give it to me because of all the things that have happened that have kind of caused me to not finish this degree because it's a lot for me to juggle and I'm just being real. Like I said, I'm a mom, full-time teacher. At home, I take care of my parents who live with me and my uncle. I'm the sole provider of my household. So there's a lot of different things on my plate. And right now the dissertation seems like a huge monster. And I have all the little monsters that I want to deal with before I deal with that huge monster. But I hope I can get there soon. But basically that's how long it's taken me. It doesn't have to take me that long. I have a friend who actually finished her PhD in like 5 years. But it does take a little longer because you're only allowed to take the most 2 classes per semester. And there's a lot of different classes that you have to take, at least for the program that I'm participating in. Number 3, was your degree online or face-to-face? My degrees, both of them were face-to-face. That's just the way that I like to learn. I know that there's a lot of amazing programs available online, which provides a lot of flexibility for a lot of people that are in my situation. But for me, I know the kind of learner I am. I have to be able to physically go to a classroom and sit in front of a professor and interact with my classmates. That's just the way that I learn best. So all my courses for both my master's and my PhD program were face-to-face, and they're also from the same university as well. Question number 4, I kind of answered this one a little bit already. How many classes did you take per semester? So like I said, with my PhD program, the most they will let you take is 2, but they actually told me, slow down, this is not a race, it's a journey. So then I went down to 1 to make it more easier for me to handle as I work and I'm a mom and all the different things. For my master's though, I can't remember off the top of my head, but if I do remember the exact number, I'll scroll it down here. But I'm thinking it was probably 2 classes per semester. I'll double check, but I'm thinking that's what it was. Question number 5, why did you choose to go to grad school? The reason I chose to go to grad school was because I actually love to learn. I love learning new techniques and new ways to implement it in my instruction and help my students and help teachers around me because I love to also provide professional development. So I just basically did it because I am passionate about learning, and technology for me, for my master's, was something I'm really passionate about, and I was really excited to complete that degree program. And then I thought after my master's, there was no way I was going back to grad school. Well, from 2008 to 2012, that was 4 years. It took me 4 years to finally say, you know what? I kind of feel like going back to school because I love to learn. And even though in the middle of all that, I may have regretted it a couple of times because of all the deadlines and all the papers and all the stress that comes with juggling all these things at once, but I still would do it all over again because I'm still learning and I'm implementing it in different ways in my classroom and outside of my classroom. So that's basically my main reason for going to grad school, is just because I love to learn and I love to stay current and just grow in my knowledge base. Now, there is an upside that our district does provide a salary increase. So for my master's, I do get about $3,600 additional on top of my base salary. And when I complete my PhD program, that $3,600 will go up to $7,400 or something like that. And that will go on top of my base salary. Now, it's not combined, it's one or the other. I can only have the $3,000 or the $7,000. Obviously, if you're taking a PhD and you've done all the work, you just take the higher pay. And that is a little extra incentive for getting a graduate degree, but it's not required in my particular district. Question number 6, how much of your time outside of teaching was or is devoted to your studies? Okay, with me, since I'm juggling my schedules, a lot of my outside time outside of the classroom, whatever time I can allot, apart from being a mom and being the head of the household, I allot to my studies. Now, currently, I have been struggling with writing my dissertation, and my brain just doesn't want to deal with it, so I'm working on getting my brain and convincing it to just get it done. But right now, I was trying to see if maybe 1 or 2 days a week, I can dedicate a chunk of time, whether it's 3 to 4 hours with breaks, of course, in between, for me to just sit down and write this dissertation. But because my deadline is gonna come up soon, I just should just bite the bullet, and any extra time that I can add in there. Of course, making sure I still give myself enough time for self-care and family time and all the other things that come with my job, I'm going to try to make it happen. But with my master's, is any little time that I could squeeze in between being a mom of a toddler at that time, I dedicated to my studies. Question number 7, who supported you? Advisors, admin, coworkers, family, and friends. I'll have to say all of the above. I couldn't have completed my master's and all of the course requirements for my PhD without the help of my parents, especially my mom, who took care of my son when I had to go to class and had to work on papers and study and meet with study buddies at Starbucks to get things done. So thank you, mom, thank you, dad. Also, my advisors at school and my professors were really, really supportive, and they really, really were there for me when I really needed them. And if I was going through something difficult, they would make sure that they would check up on me to make sure that I was okay. So I really thank everyone and my friends who encouraged me. So yeah, having a good support system is definitely important if you're going to grad school, especially if you already are a full-time teacher and if you have a family of your own or if you're a parent. That support system really, really is crucial. Number 8, share a positive experience. So my most recent positive experience will have to be with my PhD program. As a result of one of the research studies that I conducted with real participants, I got an opportunity to share my findings at the Florida Reading Association, which is an annual conference. So I was actually a speaker and a presenter at a real research-based conference where I got to share my research and have an audience to interact with. So that is a really cool positive experience that I have been able to have as a result of being in my graduate studies. And that's the most recent one that I can remember because my master's was so long ago that I can't really think of one. But one interesting class during my master's that I still remember to this day was the one where we had to put a computer apart into pieces and then put it back together. That was really cool. That was fun. All right, so now on to question number 9. Share a stressful experience and how you overcame it. So let's go back to maybe my second semester in my PhD program, and or maybe it was my third or fourth. I had a huge paper that I needed to write, and I had been juggling with different things at school, and it was around the winter break time, just before winter break, and I had to finish all of these assignments, plus all of these different demands for my job, plus all of the different things with my son, and I was just super, super overwhelmed. I had forced myself to write this paper. I was trying to stay up all night writing it, and I had a mental breakdown. I'm just keeping it real. I just started crying because I just couldn't continue on, and I felt like a failure. And that's when I thought, you know what, why don't you just reach out to the professor and see what happens? And I did reach out to her, and she was so understanding, and she was able to give me an extension on those assignments so that I had enough time to finish that paper and turn it in and not have it affect me negatively. So I'm very grateful for that. And that is my tip for you. If you are in a grad program that has strict deadlines and you just don't know how you're going to make it, because maybe you're going through what I was going through at the time, a mental breakdown, or just an overload of things happening around you. Like at one point, my car got tires that were getting like nails in it like every week. And I was having issues at home with the roof leaking in my house. Or I was having AC conditioning problems at home where the AC stopped working and we didn't have AC for like half a year trying to figure out how to get it working again. So if you have those moments that are very stressful and overwhelming and they just take over your life, reach out to your advisors, to your professors, to anyone in the university that can like listen, and you never know, they might be able to help you out in any way that they can. So that's a good advice. And I think I just answered another question. All right, which is number 10, the last question. What advice do you have for teachers who are hesitant about grad school or are having a hard time? And I apologize, I know this is already towards the end of the video, but I'm looking down because I'm reading the paper to make sure I am answering the questions correctly. All right, so if you are having a hard time thinking about going to grad school, my advice to you would be to think about all the reasons why you would want a graduate degree. Maybe your district requires you to have a master, or maybe you're like me, you just love to learn learn. So think about all those things first, and also think about how much it will cost. Will this be something that will be for free, or could you get any scholarships or any grants that can help support your program? Those are the things that I would think about if I were a teacher that was going into grad school. Also look around in your area if you want to do a face-to-face and see what types of programs your local colleges and universities are offering, if there's anything that's interesting to you. Maybe ask to speak to someone in that department and maybe interview them about the program. And if you are able to speak to students who are currently on the program, that'll be great. Or maybe sit in a class and see if that's something that you would like to do. Some universities can offer that as well. And also make sure that you look into how much it's going to cost you in the long run, because you don't want to pay for a degree that at the end of the day is not going to be cost effective for you. And if you're able to get into programs that are free, or part of it is tuition reduced, I know that there's some universities in my neighborhood that do offer that for teachers. That's another option to consider. If you want to do online degree programs, definitely look into degree programs that maybe offer a flexible path for you, where you can set your own deadlines and decide how many classes you're going to take each semester. So all of those things are very important for you to consider. And if you have any questions, feel free to leave them in the description box below, and I'll be sure to answer them if I haven't answered them already. So that is the collab for the teachers in grad school. I hope you were able to learn a little bit about my experience as a grad student. I am still currently a grad student. Hopefully I can get all graduated in a feasible time. So we'll see how all that goes. Wish me luck, because I need to get that dissertation done. And like my professors always tell me, a good dissertation is a done dissertation. So I gotta get it done. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, don't forget to hit the like button, leave a comment down below, let me know what you thought or any questions you may have. Also, if you haven't subscribed, please consider subscribing and hitting the bell for notifications so you don't miss any future videos. I hope you have a beautiful, magical day, and don't forget to smile. Hello, dreamers, wishers, and magical thinkers. Thank you so much for making it to the very end of this video and for showing your support. If you'd like to subscribe, you can do so by clicking on my picture down here. You can also check out my latest videos here and here. Don't forget to believe in the magic that's inside you, because you are capable of great things. See you next time.